Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. Here's what you need to know for this Friday, August 6th. In an announcement that was not unexpected, Governor Murphy will require school kids to mask up in grades K through 12 when new classes resume in September. The state is still set to resume full-time in-person classes. The governor had been holding off, hoping to see how other states dealt with the spread of the Delta variant. But the formal announcement and the new mask mandate is expected to come later today. We have full coverage of everything you need to know about back to school at NJ1015.com. With New York City requiring proof of vaccination to enter bars and restaurants and most events, the city of Hoboken on our side of the river is considering something similar. Councilman Michael DeFusco, whose ward includes plenty of bars and restaurants downtown, wants to offer bars a financial incentive if they will deny access to the unvaccinated. Now, the mayor of Hoboken, Ravi Bala, has said all issues are on the table to try and increase vaccination rates in his city, but hasn't commented directly on this. We can tell you some bar owners already don't like it. At least one told NJ.com he has a hard enough time proving people are 21 with all the fake IDs, and worries that fake vaccination cards will start to pop up. That's already happening. And a lot of college kids have been buying them for up to $200 a piece. No direct evidence it's happening in New Jersey, but it is happening in other states, and the FBI has announced a crackdown. College kids are buying them to prove vaccination status so they don't get kicked out of school. A number of New Jersey schools are requiring vaccination for the fall semester, and it will deregister students that have not uploaded proof of their vaccination status. Even with the COVID metrics stabilizing somewhat in New Jersey, the number of positive tests is increasing, but so are the number of those tests. The spot positivity rate, 5.43 this morning. The rate of transmission is at 1.37, indicating spread of the virus. Hospitalizations have increased at 599, less than 100 are needing life-supporting care. You already know about the Delta variant. Get ready to hear more about Lambda and Epsilon, which were first discovered in California and Peru, respectively. The CDC says they are now variants of interest. There is growing concern because not only are they more easily transmitted, they are also in early studies showing a resistance to vaccine. Who knew that processing weed smells like a skunk? The folks in Reddington Township and Hunterdon County sure didn't. Not until a weed cultivation and processing plant moved into an abandoned Walmart in town. The stench has been so bad that residents have been complaining for weeks, if not months. There are plans in place to scrub the air with new technology and equipment to be installed, but the approval process to allow that installation to continue has been a long one. Think Megan's Law, but for hate crimes. A growing number of New Jersey lawmakers are supporting a bill that would produce an online registry of anyone convicted of a hate or bias crime. There are some civil liberties concerns here. Sponsors of the bill say it would provide details about hate crime convictions and accessible to the public with a searchable database. Penalties would be included if anybody used that data to commit a crime against somebody listed on that registry. Last week, five tornadoes touched down in New Jersey. Fortunately, there was a lot of damage, but no deaths attributed to it. Still, state lawmakers and other state officials want to try to make sure you know what to do and understand the language and terminology of tornado watches and warnings and the like. We have expanded coverage on that at NJ1015.com this morning. This is not a murder hornet. This is a cicada killer wasp. You may be seeing it in your yard or in parks or on golf courses. It is big. It is scary looking, but overall, it is not a threat. A professor of entomology at Rutgers says if you see one, don't kill it. They're generally harmless to humans. They are not aggressive, but they are a nightmare to cicadas, which they inject with venom and then feed to their young. And then we have this story coming out of Howell Township this morning. The story of a couple of escaped ponies and some alert police officers who made sure that they were safe and returned to their owners. Two Howell police officers rounded up these ponies who had escaped from a summer riding camp on Casino Drive. The officers closed off an adjacent road. They actually tracked the ponies with a drone to try to capture them and return them to the farm. They say on Facebook, when the two mischievous ponies escaped from the summer camp, Howell officers were called in for assistance. These ponies were running through backyards, stopping occasionally to eat vegetation. Horses on adjacent properties aided in their escape by running around their pens, creating a dust cloud to obstruct our views as the suspects ran past. Ultimately, they were able to capture the ponies unharmed and return them to the farm. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we are always talking Jersey, taking your phone calls on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's what you need to know for this Friday, August 6th. Have a great weekend.